I'm Ron Patterson with Utah State University Extension in Weber and Morgan counties. Weeds do not recognize property boundaries and really are everybody's problem. Today's weed warrior topic is whitetop or hoarycress. Whitetop is a creeping perennial in the mustard family. Because it is a creeping, spreading perennial, whitetop grows in dense clusters and is really quite easy to recognize in the spring, especially when it's in bloom. Whitetop will germinate in the summer and spring, and then it sends down that taproot. It goes down about 12 inches in about 30 days. After about 21 days, they'll start sending out runners or rhizomes, and you can see from this view here that you'll have several plants come up from rhizomes. Now these rhizomes, which are actually underground stems or a modified stem, some people call it a horizontal root, but it's actually a stem, and you can see that it will send up shoots along here. And if you end up cutting up that stem in your mechanical removal efforts, you'll get new plants come from those split up rhizomes. Notice that the leaf color of whitetop is kind of a gray green, and these basal leaves have a petiole down to the stem. On the other hand, the leaves that are on the flower stalk, while still that gray green color, are actually clasping. They come right down to that flower stalk. The flowers of whitetop are white, which makes sense. They have four petals, and then there's this cluster of them, kind of a flat top cluster. As with all weed problems that we have, prevention is the best cure. So if we can keep these from getting into our place, that's great. So clean your equipment, your farm, construction, ATV equipment where you've been operating from, and be very careful of where you're getting soil from. You see a lot of piles of soil that have whitetop on them. Those have typically had the roots of the rhizomes come in with that pile of soil so that it then takes place, sets up its clonal colony, and starts to spread the seed. Weed-free hay is a very important part of weed prevention. Be sure the hay has been cut before the weeds have gone to seed. Good pasture management is really important with weed control. You want to have the good plants competing with the weeds so that they will do better. You spray down your weeds, but if you don't have good plants taking up there, the weeds will come right back. So don't overgraze your pastures. Graze them properly, manage them properly, and that will help a lot with your weed control efforts. Whitetop has no biological controls, at least from the insects and disease point of view, but sheep and goats will graze it. The problem with that is that they'll usually graze the more desirable plants first, then they'll go to the whitetop, so that just gives the whitetop a competitive advantage. Probably not the best way to go with using sheep and goats to graze your whitetop. So because whitetop spreads mostly by rhizomes, using a shovel or a tiller or cultivation equipment is not really the best way to control it, but you can do it. If you do that for 3 or 4 years and you make sure you pull up all the roots, you have to do it on a regular basis about every 10 days in order for it to be effective. So if you've got the time and you don't have a very big plot, you can dig it up and take care of it with the mechanical removal. Although whitetop does spread mostly by rhizomes, it also does spread by seed. The seeds are fairly short-lived, maybe five to seven years in the nature, but in the lab about 5 years is what they've been able to get the seed to survive. The most common way for a seed to spread is to get down into the water, coming down here with rainfall or whatever, down into the irrigation ditches and rivers and streams. And so trying to keep the whitetop and the other weeds away from the rivers and streams will help a lot in prevention. The main keys then to controlling whitetop is to stop the seed production, which you can do by mowing, but you also need to kill the roots, which you can't do by mowing. You need to get those roots killed, and so herbicides usually the best way to do that. If your non-herbicide control options are not going to work for you, there are some broadleaf weed controls that can work. There's 2,4-D, Tel-R, and Escort. Tel-R is chlorosulfuron, Escort is metsulfuron. 2,4-D does not have a lot of soil activity, so it will not control the germinating seeds, but it does work on the smaller seedlings and the rosette stage of the whitetop. Tel-R and Escort both have good soil activity, so it will control the germinating seedlings as well as when you get into this bud stage. Tel-R is really good in the flowering stage, so at this point when you're in full bloom, Tel-R is a good product to use. And Escort is perhaps not quite so late in the blooming stage, more of a bud stage, but that works quite well. They all are really quite good in the fall when you're treating the rosette or seedlings, and then in the springtime, early in the springtime, 2,4-D, later in the springtime, Telar or Escort would be pretty good options as far as herbicides go. Your non-selective herbicide options are glyphosate or imazapyr, and they will kill everything in that you spray. The glyphosate has no soil activity. Glyphosate is like Roundup or Kills All, or there's several names with glyphosate. That's the common chemical name. So glyphosate will kill everything. Imazapyr will also kill everything, but it has soil activity, and so you will have a period of time where you're not going to get any regrowth of anything coming through there. So imazapyr is a good non-selective herbicide, and it's actually labeled on water, but it's not a good option if you want to be planting back in the area. I've placed some links in the video description below that will give you more information on herbicide options to control whitetop. Be sure to always read and follow the label directions. Whitetop is a serious weed issue in Utah, but ignoring it will not make it go away. Everybody needs to do their part. So be a good neighbor, be a weed warrior.